Hey crypto friends, how's it going? I'm Michael Selbe. In today's video, I want to check what my experiment with PlanetWatch has done for me in the first month. 1 month ago, I purchased the Atmotube Pro air sensor on Amazon. And I also purchased a license from PlanetWatch so that I can upload the data from the air sensor to the Algorand blockchain. That was the Type 4 license from PlanetWatch. Then I installed the PlanetWatch app on my Android phone, and there it is. It's nice, it's colorful, it's very practical. I mean, with this sensor, we were really able to see how much our air gets polluted when we fry something with oil in our kitchen, or when we have a barbecue outdoor on our terrace and we use a charcoal grill. So I think we are now caring more about our air, so the sensor was a really good investment into our health. Now, let's see how we have done. I will go to the Explorer on the PlanetWatch website. And the first thing that I can see there is that the price of the Planet token went up. When I started, it was at 11.5 cents and now it's on 13.224 cents. So the Planet token went up. This is awesome because the reward from PlanetWatch is paid in Planet tokens. I really like that. I will go on to the Algo Explorer that is showing us the Algorand blockchain. Over there, I can paste my PlanetWatch wallet address into the search field. And then it shows me how data streams are written for my wallet address every 10 minutes, like over here, 14 minutes ago, 25 minutes ago, 35 minutes ago, and so on. And then once per day, there's one transaction, like this one over here, where a reward is paid. The whole thing started 30 days ago with a new sensor, my Atmotube Pro sensor being registered over here, and then the data streams started. Over here, I can check the current balance of my PlanetWatch wallet, and it has got 653.376 planets. That's surprisingly close to the maximum amount of planets I could get as a reward for this sensor in 1 month. The maximum for 30 days would be 691 planets. I think 653 comes pretty close. I mean, of course, there are always occasions when my phone cannot transmit data and then I miss data streams over here and then some planets are deducted from the rewards. Now, there was one occasion when my phone ran out of battery. On another occasion, I was using the phone as a video camera and I switched it to airplane mode because I didn't want anything to disturb the recording. So yes, I will always miss some transmissions, but it seems like it doesn't affect the total amount of planets all that much. That's something I like. What I would like to do with my planets is sending it over to my exchange and then let the exchange handle the selling of the planets. Because on the one hand, I've seen the Planet token went up in price, so it's okay to hold it for now. On the other hand, when it goes down, then I want it to be sold and my exchange can handle that better than I can do that manually. So let's go over to bitfinex.com. And over there, I need to create a deposit address. I go to wallet, deposit, then to cryptocurrencies. I search for planets. And then I have to click to generate an address for the exchange wallet. I have never sent any planets to Bitfinex. That's why I have to generate the address. Otherwise, it would be already here. So this is where I have to send my planets. I copy that. And now I need the Algorand wallet to actually send the planets. Let me go on my phone to the Algorand wallet. There I've got the account that I created, Algo64, and the account that PlanetWatch created. And this is where the planets reside. So I go there, click on send, click on max to have the maximum amount sent over, then on address, and here I paste in the receiving address that Bitfinex created for me. I don't need a note. I can preview the whole thing. That looks good. So I tap on send planets. It took about half an hour for the deposit to be confirmed, but now I should be ready to use the planets over here. I go to trading, and in the tickers I search for planets, click on the USDT pair, and if I would sell them right now with a market order, I would get $86.18 roughly. But I don't want to do that. I will copy my amount of planets from this field and change from market order to trailing stop. I paste in my amount of planets over here and I choose the distance. Let's say half a cent. What that means is whenever the planets drop half a cent in price, then the stop order should be executed. I activate that by clicking on exchange sell, and that's active. What now happens is, in the worst case, planets would just go down in price from now on, and I would sell at 12.675 cents. Okay, that would be okay. What could also happen is that planets would continue to go up in price like they did over the past 4 weeks. And whenever they then drop by half a cent, I would sell. The ideal case would be if I could catch such a spike like over here. Our planets went up to something like 20 cents. If I catch such a spike with a trailing stop order, it would go all the way up to 20 cents and it would drop to 19.5 cents. And there I would sell. I don't expect to be that lucky, but this order can sell my planets better for me than I could do manually. The one thing that I have to tell you is all of this is no financial advice. Trading coins can lose you money, so do your own research and take your own decisions. Okay, let's put all my numbers into an overview sheet so that we really see where we are standing. I created this little table. If you like to simply download it, go to michaelselbel.io. You can have it over there. So the first line would be, what do I have in my PlanetWatch wallet? This is zero. The next line is, how many planets did I already withdraw? That was 653, and they had a value of about $86. So the immediate result just on the PlanetWatch side is $44, because I purchased a license for $42, I got $86, so I already broke even. That's cool. But how about the sensor? I purchased the sensor for €179, that's $210. And if I would sell the sensor right now, let's see what it would be worth. On eBay, there are Atmotube Pros, which are roughly 1 month old. One of them is currently standing at €276 in an auction. It will still go up in the next 4.5 hours, but I would say people pay at least €276. There are others which you can buy directly for around about €500. Okay, but let's say 276 euro. That's over here. 276. How many US dollars would that be? 325.58 US dollars. Okay, let's put that into the sheet. Then I would have gained $115 on the sensor, but I wouldn't really look at that because on the one hand, I see the sensor not really as an investment in this position anymore. I see it as an investment into my health. And at the same time, I'm not intending to sell it right now. So this part is irrelevant in my opinion. But the relevant part just tells me, okay, I broke even in the first month on the license costs. So that seems to work really well. My takeaway is that PlanetWatch is working beautifully for me. The ROI is going to be excellent after 1 year. So I would like to get a few more sensors and I'm going to buy more licenses. So on PlanetWatch, I'm planning to purchase 2 Type 3 licenses. These are high-end sensors for indoor, and I want to use them in my house. And I want to purchase 1 Type 1 license for an outdoor sensor. This license is special in a way that the rewards depend on how populated the area is that you live in. So for tier 1 areas, which are more populated, you get much higher rewards than for tier 2 areas. I'm living in such a tier 2 area. My rewards will not be so high for type 1, but it should still break even in a year. And I really want to have such a sensor. So this is my plan going forward. I might do another review video after 1 year. If you found this video useful, I would be happy about a thumbs up. And until I look at PlanetWatch again, I will probably try out a lot of other DeFi opportunities. And if you want to see that, please subscribe to the channel. I really hope I see you in the next video.